In this video, I am going to discuss about shielded metal arc welding. Shielded metal arc welding is one of the oldest, simplest, and most versatile joining processes. About 50% of all the industrial and maintenance welding is done by this method. The electric arc is generated by touching the tip of a coated electrode against the workpiece and withdrawing it quickly to a distance sufficient to maintain the arc. Electric arc is a discharge of electric current across a gap in the circuit. The electrodes are in shape of thin, long round rods that are held manually, hence the process is also referred to as stick welding. Working principle. Shielded metal arc welding is carried out closely just as arc welding process. It also uses an AC or DC power supply that transfers current to the electrode holder in order to produce an arc leading to intense heat to melt the tip of the electrode and joining the portion of the workpiece with the arc. This arc length is maintained by the welder by holding a consistent space between the electrode and the weld pool that is a form on the workpiece. This workpiece bonds as soon as the arc is taken off it and then joint is obtained. The current, which may be DC or AC, usually ranges from 50 to 300 ampere. Working. In this case of shielded metal arc welding, in order to strike the arc, the electrode is brought into contact with workpiece by a very light touch of the electrode to the base metal and then pulled back slightly. This process initiates the electric arc and hence the melting of the workpiece and the consumable electrode. The heat generated melts a portion of the electrode tip, its coating, and the base metal in the immediate arc area. This causes droplets of the electrodes to be passed from the electrode to the weld pool. The molten metal consists of a mixture of base metal, which is the workpiece, electrode metal, and the substance from the coating on the electrode. This mixture becomes weld when it solidifies. The electrode coating deoxidizes the weld area and provides a shielding gas to protect it from oxygen in the environment. A bare section at the end of the electrode is first clamped to one terminal of the power source, while other terminal is connected to the workpiece being welded. As the slag floats on the surface of weld pool and protects the weld from contamination as it solidifies. Slag is formed when the flux, the solid shielding material used in the welding process, melts in or on the top of the weld zone. As the slag floats on the surface of the weld pool and protect the weld from the contamination as it solidifies, once the slag is hardened, it must be chipped away to reveal the finished weld. As the welding progresses, the electrode melts, the welder must periodically stop welding to remove the remaining electrode stub and insert a new electrode to the electrode holder. This process is best suitable for workpiece thickness of 3 to 19 mm, although this range can be easily be extended by skilled operators using multiple pass techniques. The multiple pass approach requires that slag be removed after each weld bed. Unless removed completely, the solidified slag can cause severe corrosion of the weld area and thus lead to failure of the weld. Also, it prevents fusion of weld layers, compromising weld strength. The slag can be removed by wire brushing or by chipping of the weld. Shield metal welding. DC is referred because of the steady arc it produces. Power requirements generally are less than 10 kilowatt. The equipment consists of power supply, cables, and an electrode holder. Advantages. The shielded metal arc welding is a versatile welding process, that is, this method can be used for welding of various metals. The equipment used for shielded metal arc welding is cheap and simple. Shielded metal arc welding is suitable for outdoor applications also. Advantages. With this welding method, the welding process is discontinuous as the electrode needs to be replaced. Fumes produced from makes the welding process control difficult. With the shielded metal arc welding, the weld may contain slag inclusions. Labor cost and material cost are both are high. For welding process in the maintenance and repair industry, used in the construction of steel structure, shipbuilding, pipelines and in industrial fabrication, used to weld iron and steel, including stainless steel, used to weld aluminium, nickel and copper alloys, useful for work in remote areas where a portable fuel powered generator can be used as power supply.